Hi guys, I'm back with another lecture of Principles of Management, and in this lecture I'm going to continue with the unit 4, and we'll cover one or two topics in this lecture of that unit. So before we start, just a brief introduction about myself. So I'm Sandhya Rao, working as an assistant professor at St. Andrew's Institute of Technology and Management. So in the last lecture, I talked about the nature, purpose, and process of controlling. In this lecture, I'll talk about the importance of management control and why people actually resist to control. Okay, so let's get started. All right, so controlling is an integral part of any management. It's very much important and it's very much required in every organization. Okay, as I've told you that, you know, planning always requires controlling, and planning is something which is all pervasive. So likewise, controlling also becomes all pervasive. So that is why it becomes even more important. So let's understand it by these following points, which will make it more clear as to why it's more important. So the first reason why I'm saying that it's very important is because it guides the manager in achieving the predetermined goals. As I've told you that, you know, in controlling, we set standards, we set certain goals, and that's what we do in planning, okay? So controlling tries to check and also helps the management to achieve those predetermined goals. Because if we are deviating from those goals, then definitely controlling will keep that in check, and it will help us to, you know, get back on track. So a continuous flow of information helps the managers to know as to when we actually need to implement the controlling techniques. Okay, proper timely aap check kar rahe ho, आप प्रॉपर राउंड्स पे जा रहे हो, प्रॉपर इंस्पेक्शन कर रहे हो टाइम टू टाइम, तो आपको इन्फॉर्मेशन मिलती रहेगी कि कैसे कैसे चीजें जो है वो वर्क कर रही हैं, कैसे कि किस डायरेक्शन में चीजें जो है वो वर्क कर रही हैं. सो इफ यू फील एट एनी पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम दैट यू नो थिंग्स आर डेविएटिंग और थिंग्स आर नॉट मूविंग एज वी प्लान देम टू मूव, देन यू कैन टेक द करेक्टिव एक्शन प्लान. आप उसी टाइम पे अपने कंट्रोलिंग टेक्निक्स यूज करके चीजों को वापस से ट्रैक में ला सकते हो. सो इट गाइड्स द मैनेजमेंट इन अचीविंग द प्रीडिटरमिंड गोल, क्योंकि हमारा हर सब कुछ जो है वो हमारे गोल्स के अकॉर्डिंग चलता है. हमारे जो प्रीडिटरमिंड ऑब्जेक्टिव्स हैं, उन्हीं के हिसाब से हम अपनी डायरेक्शन को सेट करते हैं. ओके, सो इट हेल्प्स द मैनेजमेंट इन डूइंग दैट. द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज इट इंश्योर्स इफेक्टिव यूज ऑफ स्कार्स एंड वैल्यूएबल रिसोर्सेज. सी इन मैनेजमेंट इट बिकम्स वेरी नेसेसरी दैट यू नो यू do optimum utilization of resources. We all know that resources are scarce in nature, which means that, you know, they're not available in abundant quantity. Resources are scarce. That is why we study all these economics and management, because resources are scarce in nature and also they are valuable. So we need to ensure that, you know, we use them in optimum, we use them optimally. Okay, so control system helps in improving the organizational efficiency. Controlling will also ensure that minimum wastage happens in the organization, and various control devices act as motivators to managers that, you know, performance of every person is regularly monitored, and if you keep certain checks on the performance and on the on the performance of your employees, then definitely you can place certain reward system also or punishment system also, which will act as a motivator for the employees. Because if you're going to reward them for efficient performance, agar bachche se utilization kare, resources ki optimum utilization, then you can reward them, then definitely it can act as a motivator for employees. It's because control puts a psychological pressure in the mind of the individual. On the other hand, control also enables management to decide whether employees are doing right things or not. The next is it facilitates coordination. Controlling definitely helps to maintain coordination in the organization, because when different departments are working independently, there are high chance that, you know, they might start having conflicts among them. So controlling will ensure an effective coordination system in place. every manager will try to coordinate the activities of his subordinates in order to achieve the departmental goal. Okay. Similarly, the executive, the chief executive officer also tries to control, coordinate the functions of various departments. So, जब आप coordination कर रहे हो तो वो भी एक तरह का controlling ही है, because that is how you are trying to ensure optimum utilization of resources, minimum wastages, and also timely execution होगा चीजों का, then definitely आप time पे अपनी deadline पे अपने objectives को meet up कर पाओगे, because end goal आपका यही है that you need to achieve your set objectives. Okay, so it facilitates coordination, because coordination से ये चीजें जो हैं ये smoothly run करेंगी. So control acts as a check on the performance, and proper results are achieved only when the activities are coordinated. Then next is leads to delegation and decentralization of authority. See, in every organization, when the size of organization increases, the managers tend to delegate their authority to their subordinates, because one person cannot handle all the things. All right. But the thing is that sometimes we have to dilute the control that we exercise on our subordinates or on the things that are under our control, which for which we are responsible. Okay. But when we have to delegate the authority, we have to dilute that control, because we have to give some authority to our subordinates. तो वो डिपेंड करता है अब आप किस चीज को यूज करते हो, आप डेलीगेशन को यूज करते हो या डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन को यूज करते हो, बट कंट्रोलिंग विल ऑलवेज एंश्योर डेलीगेशन एंड अथॉरिटी, बिकॉज व्हेन डेफिनेटली द साइज इंक्रीजेस, टू एंश्योर प्रॉपर कोऑर्डिनेशन, डेलीगेशन एंड डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन विल बी रिक्वायर्ड. सो अ डिसीजन, फॉर एग्जाम्पल, अ डिसीजन अबाउट फॉलो अप एक्शन इज ऑल्सो फैसिलिटेटेड. Control makes delegation easier or better. Decentralization will happen in case of big enterprises, and management cannot delegate authority without ensuring proper control. As I've told you, when you delegate your authority, you have to dilute your control. Okay, and for that you will have to ensure proper controlling techniques, proper control mechanism should be there. डायरेक्ट कंट्रोल कैन नॉट बी एक्सरसाइज इन डेलीगेशन, क्योंकि फिर आप जो एक्सेस है वो किसी और पर्सन को, थर्ड पर्सन को दे देते हो. देन द टारगेट और गोल्स ऑफ द वेरियस डिपार्टमेंट्स आर यूज्ड एज अ कंट्रोल टेक्निक. ओके, एंड तब आप फिर एक ही कंट्रोल एक्सरसाइज कर सकते हैं कि ऑर्गेनाइजेशन का जो गोल है वो अल्टीमेटली अचीव होना चाहिए. बट इफ आई टॉक अबाउट डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन, तो वहां पे आपको अपना पर्सनल कंट्रोल डाइल्यूट करने की जरूरत नहीं पड़ती है. यू डू नॉट लूज कंट्रोल ओवर द एक्टिविटीज. एग्जाम्पल आर बजटिंग, कॉस्ट कंट्रोल, प्री एक्शन अप्रूवल, ऑल दीज काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स रिक्वायर डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन, क्योंकि ये हर अलग अलग डिपार्टमेंट के थ्रू ही किया जा सकता है. वन सिंगल पर्सन कैन नॉट डू इट, एंड दैट इज वाई इट विल अलाउ डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन. And also you will not lose your control, क्योंकि आपका जो control है वो आपके पास ही रहेगा. Your power will remain with you only. And next is pairs top management to concentrate on policy making. This is nothing but the extension of the earlier point. कि जब आप delegation या decentralization करते हो तो आपके पास time काफी spare में रहता है. You can focus on those area where your specialization or your expertise is more required, and you can definitely find more time to focus on these areas, because the routine nature of work and the other things wherein you know your attention is not much required, you can easily delegate those tasks or those activities to your subordinates, and you can focus on more important aspects. So this is what the importance of controlling is. Now moving on to the next topic, that's resistance to controlling, which means that why people oppose control. Time and again we have seen that, you know, whenever you try to control anybody, people tend to oppose, people tend to resist that, no, you cannot control us, we'll do it on our own way, or we'll do it on our own terms. So why is it like that? Why people oppose control? Now there are certain reasons behind it, and different theories revolve around it. So first one is that, you know, in the recent times we see that more organic forms of organizations are coming up, which are more self-organizing and more self-managed and network organizations, wherein people don't exercise much control on the subordinates and they are allowed to work on their own terms. There is a huge scope of creativity as well. So it allows organization to be more responsive and adaptable to today's changing environment. And here we try to empower our employees, which means that we give power to them and we do not try to suppress them. We do not try to control them. And much more than the hierarchical and rigidity and rigid structures that we had in past. So in contrast to the past organizational structures that we had, which were more rigid in nature, these new organic forms of organization are more flexible in nature. They provide a lot of flexibility to the employees and they don't exercise much control. Then also, most people say that the nature of organization has changed, so must the change of management control. क्योंकि मैनेजमेंट जो है ऑर्गेनाइजेशन जो है स्ट्रक्चर जो है वो चेंज हो रहा है. पहले काफी ब्यूरोक्रेटिक या काफी जो यहाँ के लीडरशिप स्टाइल्स भी थे वो ऑटोक्रेटिक होते थे. अब क्योंकि सारी चीजें जो है वो लेजर फ्री टाइप स्टाइल में आ रही हैं, तो कंट्रोल जो मैनेजमेंट कंट्रोल जो है उसको भी चेंज कर देना चाहिए, उसमें भी मॉडिफिकेशन करनी चाहिए. दिस इज वन स्कूल ऑफ थॉट. So people claim that, you know, management should not exercise any form of control whatsoever be the situation is. So it basically means that in whatever be the situation, management should not control exercise. Management should not exercise control over their employees. And they also say that the role of management is to cooperate with the employees and to increase the morale of your employees. So in order to do that, they should definitely abandon the control system. So they, in order to make the employees more productive, they need the management need to be more supportive. And control is completely counterproductive to management and employees. This is another theory. Then another theories that revolve around are that people react strongly against the phrase management control. So people say that, you know, this in itself is a negative connotation. It sounds more dominating, coercive and heavy-handed. So this management control term should not be there. It seems that writers of management literature now prefer using the term coordinating rather than controlling. So we have tried to modify it and we use the term coordination. Coordination basically means that, you know, the managers and the employee should move in line with each other. So both these two parties should accept the goals of each other and they should work cohesively towards the achievement of each other's goal. Rather than using the term control or, you know, management control, we have started using coordinating. And we have tried to incorporate the essence of controlling in the coordinating only. And people also say that, you know, when we try to impose control, we decrease the autonomy that an individual can have. Also, we take away the creativity that they can have and we threaten their security. Because whenever you're trying to control somebody, you are trying to impose yourself upon that person. So you are threatening the security of that particular person. And it's a kind of perpetual oppression wherein, you know, you are trying to oppress something. So this may lead to change in expertise and power structure and social structure in the organization. So people say that, you know, management control should not be there. And we should be allowed to work on our own terms. We should be allowed to be more creative. And coordination should definitely be there, but the term control should not be used anymore. So these were the reasons why people feel that, you know, management control is wrong, and that is why they resist control. So this is it for today's lecture. And the two questions that I want to give you from this lecture are that you have to explain why people resist any kind of control that is being exercised, and what is the importance of controlling. All right, thank you guys.